Jesus Christ.
From the Shivs, here to interview Reverend Beatman and Nicole Izobel Garcia on their very first U.S. legit tour.
Yeah.
Woo! Legit tour.
They're doing 10 or 12 dates up and down the West Coast. They started last week in L.A., and we are thrilled to have them here at Bottom of the Hill tonight. So, welcome.
Thank you, Reverend Beatman, and sister Nicole.
Yeah, the amazing club. It's like super killer.
We have the Easter altar for you, too. So very special occasion,
bunny.
I see.
I like bunny.
So how has the tour started off? How many dates have you done so far?
Two.
It feels like more.
So good.
Yeah, we're a little rusty, but
okay.
Yeah.
Our last tour was, I think, last year in Europe.
Last year.
It's been a while.
How many years have you been touring together?
Since 4 years.
Yeah, but really sporadic.
Every
couple years there's a show.
It goes with
there's
the bands.
A tour and stuff like that.
You go there, he comes here. But you're from Switzerland, she's from LA. So how did you meet and like what did you see in her that made you think, oh my gosh, I just need to put a nun outfit on her and bring her around? What happened here?
Well, it wasn't quite like that, but I don't know.
Maybe it was.
Yeah.
I was in Los Angeles and on a garage punk show from a band, then with a friend, and then she was there.
My friend too.
And then we were blah 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 talking, and by accident I had a show in Los Angeles a couple of days later, and normally I play in if there are bigger cities, so I have backing bands. I ask in bands if they could back me up, organ player, drummer. Mm-hmm. And she said, she's an organ player. And I said, whoa, organ player. Can you play drums? Then she said, yes, but you can't.
Yeah, I still can't, but I do. Tell him that. Reverend Beatman asks you if you can play drums, you say yes.
You say yes.
And you figure it out in 2 days.
Yeah, that's the way to do it. Yeah.
Then she hired a rehearsal place, and we rehearsed quick, and then we played together. And it was so fantastic together.
Did you see her play before?
No, never.
Okay.
I just felt it. That's something it could work.
Yeah, the energy.
And then when we play live on stage, we're totally on the same level. So
how is the creative energy? Like I watched some of your videos, obviously, since the new album's coming out. It's all fresh and unreleased, but it's pretty amazing.
Yeah, the energy's good. I mean, we both have similar aesthetic. Writing ones too.
So. You didn't mind putting on a nun outfit?
Not at all. No. I'm Catholic, so it works.
It goes with it.
Yeah.
So I'm going to mess this up, but Vale Bruja Muerto?
Mm-hmm.
What does that mean?
And sorry.
You should ask Beatman. He came up with it. What does it mean?
You know,
something's dead.
I saw it when it arrived in my house.
It's three great words. So
it works.
So I thought, oh, those three words, let's put them together and make an album title of it.
What does it mean, each word?
Like death witch dance.
Yeah.
Oh, I like that. That's what we're going to do.
Yeah.
Some death witch dance.
No, it should say that, but it doesn't.
No,
so.
I mean, it's
a
little grammatically incorrect, but it's okay.
Oh, okay.
It's okay.
It's okay.
So this record, is there any particular song on it that really is personal to either of you or that you really love? I'm sure you love all of them.
Yeah,
however.
There is.
We each wrote and recorded a few of the songs on our own, actually.
Oh, before and brought it together?
Yeah, so some of it is recorded in the studio together.
Okay.
And then the other half is just like, I sent him my stuff, he put in his stuff, and just made this crazy weird album. And it fits somehow.
That's cool.
Yeah.
It's cool how you can do that these days. You can not even be
in the
same room and make records and music together. That's amazing.
But some songs we recorded on our last tour in Italy, when we played in Italy, we went to the studio and recorded like 12 songs.
Yeah.
And from that session, there are like five on that album.
So I heard you say, I was listening to one of your 2017 recording where you have the one song where it's kind of like talking about the rules, where you say, you must go in and just take two takes and don't make it perfect. And you don't, you only come out of the studio after two takes.
Oh. Where did you hear that? That's correct. That's kind of correct.
Yeah. It's not.
That could be me.
I mean, I don't remember hearing that, but I'm just like that. I'm kind of like,
yeah.
One take, and I'm like, yeah, that's fine.
That's it, that's good.
I don't even want to think about it, because if you start thinking about it
too much.
And you start like, oh no, I got to sing this part perfect.
Right, it's
never as fresh as the first or second take.
Yeah,
so
the energy's
So we really are on the same level, so recording was super fast. That's why we got 12 songs in like, what, 2 days or something.
Oh, wow. That's really
With her, to record is really easy, but then I had another band also recording on this album, other albums.
Is that the new wave?
Yeah. And they had like only two takes, and they didn't know the song at all. So before, we made the sound check in the studio with drums and everything, and the engineer said, it's good. So then I took my guitar and played the song quick.
Yeah.
And I said, that's the song, and we have two takes.
That's perfect.
And then we played it, and the second time, They never heard the song, so. Poor guys.
That's magic. Yeah. Improv.
They were like, ah!
Improv blues trash.
I like to stress people out.
But it brings out something really creative. So.
It does.
You have to work together, or you completely fuck up. So.
Practicing too much makes crazy. Yeah. I know. We just got out of the studio, too. I'm like, no, we can't do any more. We stop now. We take the best. We just...
You have to stop.
It's more energy. So on that note, so you're touring here. You're doing the States. Like, you're here for a month doing this or so?
Yeah, it's like 3 weeks or something like that.
And then you're doing the Mighty Roots in August? Tennessee?
Yeah, our first week of September, I think it is.
Yeah, maybe? I saw there was some big names on that.
So like, we'll do East Coast, Midwest, August.
We will do another tour around that.
Before, end at the Mighty Roots.
Okay,
so that's still being booked, but...
Yeah. I saw your name on the...
Mm-hmm.
On that.
Yeah, the Mighty Roots is amazing.
I've never even heard of it before. I'm like, I'm so ashamed.
Oh, no, it's such an amazing
festival. I
want to
come. Okay.
Yeah.
Crazy good.
Yeah,
crazy
so good. That'll be good. And then you go back and do European tour. Is it Askena Festival?
We play there as well, yeah. But first we're going to go to England, I think.
Oh, yeah, in May. We go
couple
to
weeks.
I think I come with you. Do you need a bass player? I quit my job.
Maybe we do need a bass player. Yeah, UK.
Okay, so all of that.
All Europe.
But that's kind of like, so you were very underground, like all about kick the mainstream in the head. So going to these festivals, is that any way demean your dedication to like staying underground?
We are definitely underground and we like to be underground. It's really good. It's really, the community is great. People, they organize, like in this club, she knows us.
Mm-hmm.
You know, people know us, they organize us because they know the music, they love the music.
It's always better to be like family with people.
Yeah, and it's much more fun.
Yeah.
And we do music to have fun.
Yeah.
I don't make music just to make money and then go home and then fucking bullshit shit life. So, you know, this is like beautiful. We have what a great life.
Yeah, we eat so much.
We don't waste time.
All right, that's another thing you said. You said, on that song that I can't remember the name of, I'm sorry. You said, when you go on the road, you must eat all the local dish and drink all the beer.
Where
and
is it?
What is this? I'll play it for you later.
I think the Ten Commandments of Rev Beatman.
Yes, that's it. Ten Commandments. Yes. And so I want to ask you, now that you're here in California, what is your favorite beer? Do you have?
Oh, he's the beer guy.
Yeah, I like Guinness the most.
You do?
Yeah,
Guinness
in
the morning with breakfast is the best in England.
Love it.
It's like coffee. It's better than coffee. All right. So I wanted to ask you this one question. So I heard you say... things that I've heard you say. AC/DC, when you heard Angus Young play the electric guitar, was the beginning for you. So that theme of AC/DC, like good and bad, off and on, like duality. So how do you combine good and evil to bring it together in your religion? Does that make sense?
No. I think it's both the same. Yeah.
Good and evil is the same?
Yeah. If you believe in Satan, you believe in God. So. You have always bad and good inside you. It's always a struggle inside you, and there is always a fight inside you, and that makes you interesting. If they're all, for example, a soup.
Yeah.
Soup is God, for example. And salt is the devil. Soup and salt is much better. You need both.
You need a little spice.
Yeah.
If you're all good, you're boring. If you're all bad, you're dead.
No, if everything would be happy and bullshit like 1900. But it doesn't mean that I'm bad. So I love life. Life is the best. But only to see one side of life that's not it.
No.
There's always two sides. It makes it easier.
So yeah, I think so. I mean, like, all the bad stuff is so much fun, but walking that line is a hard line for a lot of people. So, you
that's
know.
A really hard line. That's why they come to my shows. So.
Yeah, that's
and
why
I
you're here
them.
To save us.
That's
yes,
why. Yeah.
This is what
that's,
I ask. What is your religion? Is the blues trash here to save the sinners and give them just enough bad to draw them back?
No, I don't have to save anything. So I just have to let them go. So, you know, just trust yourself, who you are.
Yeah.
You know, it's they don't. They want to be someone else sometimes. They want to copy something else. So.
Yeah.
And this, you see that in many bands, they want to copy this other band to sound like that because they want to be cool like this band, whatever. It's just I try to push the personality of every person. Also the bands I have on my label, I can make a super pain in the ass. Just to push that personality out, that I want to hear this person what that I know, I want to hear on that record. So
can you see in them what they can do and they don't know it?
I normally hear it on the first second I hear the recordings, what person they are. And I push that out of this person. And normally I can make some pretty interesting records.
Was there one song that really started your rock and roll crusade?
Yeah, black metal from Venom.
Really?
Oh. For me, that was the link to blues music. I grew up with my parents' rock and roll collection, 7-inch collection. I'm a mid-60s kid, born in the mid-60s, and they had this record collection with blues and rock and roll. And then this was always great music for me, Bill Haley, Elvis Presley, and so on. And then, but I was young. And then I heard on the BBC radio, Venom. Terrible recorded, awful sound. My parents hated it.
Oh.
And then I saw there is a connection. And I saw how they write the song. It's actually blues songs they play. If you listen to Venom, it's not like industrial music or techno music.
It's not
blues
like death
oriented
metal
music.
Now.
Yeah.
Norwegian death metal.
I love that.
Sorry. Nicole, what about you? What is your, like, what's one song you remember?
Well, I'm like a totally different
you're the other
generation
side.
Also.
I know. Yeah.
So when I was like, let's say 10, it's like when downloading music first came about, you know. It's
wow.
Like, oh, what can you download and all this crazy stuff. And it's probably a Monster song, actually.
Really?
I got into the Monsters.
Yeah.
And I thought it was a 60s band for a long time.
Yeah.
Like, I think it was like the Birds Eat Martians record. And I got like super into this, like, you know, like this crazy organ sounds and all this, like, just like lo-fi, whatever.
Okay.
And so, yeah, I have to remind myself of that sometimes. I'm like, oh, I'm playing with Rev Beatman now.
It's a legend.
It's cool. So,
wow.
From a young age, I've been a fan.
That's amazing. Yeah. Well, so last but not least, if there was one piece of advice you would give people to wake you up and keep life interesting, being a musician, either of you have any
I'd say just be free. Like, don't feel scared to change or try something different. If it feels right, do it. It doesn't have to be forever.
Yeah.
That's my whole thing.
Totally.
And it's get rid of the computer, stand up your butt, go to a guitar shop, buy a guitar, buy a drum kit, and start a band. That's so easy, the easiest way. No. So you're going to be saved. And this bullshit computer crap is gone. So.
Note, as I said, we're going to have a dance party in here.
Dance party!
Dance party times!
Yes.
A step to the left. Take a hammer and some nails. Mesh your head to the wall. Let your blood run cold. Now do the Jesus Christ twist. Now do the Jesus Christ twist.
crazy. Rev Beatman and Nicole Garcia.
Unto the Jesus Christ.